everybody, and welcome back to the channel, and hello to anyone who might be new and watching for the first time. So I'm doing a series of all of my colouring book collection and all the completed pages within it. And so far I have done, what have I done? I've done Rhys Van Berman and Johanna Basford before. I've done Lulu Mayer. And I've done another one, but I can't for the life of me remember what that is. Anyway, today we're continuing with Hannah Lynn. And I have four of the kind of A4 size books and three of the pocket size books. So let's just get started. So Enchanted Faces, I think this is probably my favourite of the three pocket size books that I've got. I just adore it. I primarily colour with alcohol markers in these books, and I've got Arteza Everblend, and I then usually go over that with Arteza Expert pencils. So this is the first, one of my first completed. So I'm going backwards through the book. This one I really like the colour combos I picked. I don't think you're picking up the fact there is a lot of sparkle on this hair. You're not picking it up at all, I don't think. There's a lot of stickles in the hair. I love the background and the starry sky, and I just love the fact that it's quite a limited color palette. But yeah, that's that one. So yeah, Arteza Expert pencils. I tend to use a lot of stickles. I tend to use Chromatec glitter pens around these like narrow little borders. I sometimes put washi tape around the borders, which you'll see in a minute in this book. I've done quite a few in here so far, and there's this little cozy little owl page, which is really cute. Again, there's a little bit of stickles around this hat. I did that last year. Yeah, and there's some metallic gel pen around the little border. I think this has really kind of pushed me to my limit in terms of doing skin. I'm not very good at it at all. This I think was a witch's one for October. But yeah, I had a bit of a play with my, I can't remember what it's called. It's up here somewhere. This Galaxy Glitter acrylic paint. And I've got it in varying colours. And there's some stickles, glittered glue on the tunic hood. And some of that, I think the one I've got like a clear comet, I think it's called, in that. So that's that one. So yeah, I haven't really gone further with different pens and pencils. There's one I've done with washi tape around the border. It just felt really apt with the colour choices I made in this one. It's the first time I think I'd done blonde hair, really pale blonde hair. Again, I've used stickles in this, which you're probably not picking up, it's in the clouds, and a little bit of stickles in her eyes and on the hearts. And on her wings. But yeah, this I think this is the only one I've put stickles on in the pocketbooks anyway. This was the first one I ever did in this book. I've seen a lot of people add noses. I haven't kind of broached or gone that far yet. So lots of stickles on the wings in this one, which you may or may not be able to pick up. That's a cute one. So yeah, this has pushed me out of my comfort zone in terms of doing skin. It's making me practice it. I think this is one of my favourites. There's lots of stickles on the wings there. Different hair colour for me. I love the moon. I love the background. Lots of stickles, glitter glue in there. And this is actually a watercolour paint in a golden colour, which worked quite well. You have to kind of apply lots of layers, I found, if you use watercolour in these books, because it's Amazon paper. That's this month's completed page. I won't show you that one. This is watercolour here, and the clouds have got watercolour on them as well, like an iridescent green. So it does work, but you do have to kind of layer it up to get the depth of colour. And then on here is like an Enchanted Shimmer acrylic top coat. Actually, it might not be. It might be the Art Spirits, actually, saying that in, I think it's Mermaid glitter. But yeah, that's one of my favourite, although I felt I really messed up the skin tone in this one. So I use a bit of a darker, like yellowy in places and then pink in places. But yeah, I like this one. Again, it's a different hair colour for me. I love the blend of this colour here. But yeah, that one I like. This one I think I did in February for Valentine's Day. I didn't like the hair in this one. It didn't seem to have all the lines that Hannah Lynn's hair normally has. And I think it was a bit off-putting. And I think my alcohol marker ran out. So, the brown looks a bit patchy. But again, I really like it. Lots of stickles on the wings and things. I just really like the little nature of these books. It can be quite quick. So if you want a quick... This is kind of one of my least favourites. I just don't think I picked very good colours. And I don't like where I did the hair. Yeah, it's just a meh page, that one, for me. So I think that's all the ones I've done so far in Enchanted Faces. Then this is the newest one she's done. She does have this in an A4 format as well as the pocket size. And you get double images. So one's grayscale, one's line art. And I've actually only done one in this one so far. And my daughter's done one as well. So this is my take on Tinkerbell. And I like the kind of her yellow hair. I put the stickles under her eyes. Stickles on her wings. I love the depth I've got in the fruit. Yeah, I really like that one. My daughter's done a couple in here, I think. She's doing the grayscale and I'm doing the line art. So she's done that one. And she's done halfway through that one. So yeah, that's Fierce and Fancy Fantasy Faces. Say that in a hurry. It's quite a mouthful or a tongue twister. That's that one. Then I've also got Sweet and Simple Whimsy Girls. And I really like this one as well, actually. I've done a few in here. I love this one. This reminds me of a pink lady from Greece. I think it's when Frenchie dyes her hair pink by accident. It just reminds me of her so much. But I really like the way that one turned out. I like the way there's a bit of glimmer and sparkle in her hair. And the colour, again, it's quite a limited colour palette. But yeah, really like that one. This one I did for Easter. And I added some confetti glitter in the background. Really like that one. This one I absolutely love. It's a tin girl. I just love the fact that it's all silver. There's some sparkle for the line art. Love the grey and the purple together. It was just such a simple page, but with these pops of colour of the purple and the pink heart. Just loved it. So yeah, I've only done three in that one. Then I bought Enchanted Halloween for Halloween. And I think I've only done one in here. Yeah, just one, I think. And I did this witch. And I love the way this one turned out. I love the blue and the pink against one another. Had a bit of a mess up with the eye. But never mind. Love the blue and the pink. I love the background. It's silky crayon with Sakura metallic for the little sweeties. And it's just the pops of colour. I just absolutely love it. Limited colour palette. I like the way her hair turned out. So yeah, that's really good fun. And I'm looking forward to doing more Halloweeny pictures when it comes round again in October. So that's Enchanted Halloween. Then I have also got a Whimsy Girls Christmas colouring book. So as you can see, I was adding to my seasonal colouring book collection. So my daughter's started that one. And she's done a few in here. I've done a few in here. I think there's a part completed one there, but I don't know where. I did this one. I'm not a big fan of this one. I was trying to go for the light sources kind of didn't work for me. I like the purple and the green together. They're quite Christmassy colours. The moon is like a iridescent watercolour. But I didn't like the light sources. I felt as I'd messed them up. But I quite like it overall. But I just think I could have done a better job. And then I did this one, which I think I got Colouropoly. I think I got Elf or something. Again, I quite like it, but it's quite a busy page. It was difficult to really get depth in it for me. But I like it. Very Christmassy. So that is Whimsy Girl's Christmas colouring book. Then I have Fairy Tale Princesses and Storybook Darlings. And I've only done a couple in here. Let's see. I know I've done this one. I really like this one. I love the way her hair turned out. And I don't know if I'd ever be able to replicate that again. Some glossy accents on her lips. The dress has some enchanted shimmer. Or is it dragonfly glaze? Might be dragonfly glaze acrylic top coat, which is like a blue-violet shift. I think they put that all over her dress. The water here has an enchanted shimmer on the top. And I really just like the way this page turned out. It's quite detailed. The bigger books tend to have more detailed backgrounds in. But I love the way it turned out. And especially, I'm so proud of her hair. So, yeah, that's one of my favourites in this book so far. I think I did this one last month, Wizard of Oz. And I had good fun with this one. Again, a really busy page and trying to pick out the elements that you know from Wizard of Oz, like, you know, the Yellow Brick Road, the poppies, the Emerald City, Toto, you know, all the things that you know from that film. But I think I managed it. So, so that's that one. And I don't think I've done any more in there so far. But I might do one this month because there's a hashtag for princesses. Meg's Disney Colouring, I think, is doing a enchanted year of colouring. And I think this month it's princesses. And I think this is the one I've done the most in terms of the bigger books. And this is Mermaids, Fairies and Other Girls of Whimsy. And I've done this one. There's lots and lots of glitter on the background for this. Lots of stickles. I think this is the galaxy glitter in the background. And there's stickles. There's Pentold Your Hybrid. I really like the way this one turned out. And I tried to, I put some acrylic white paint to kind of make it look as though it's foam coming up from the waterfall. So again, I really like the way that one turned out. My daughter's got this book as well, and she's done some in here. Very similar pages to mine. And there's My Australian Outback Girl. Stickles in the background for the clouds. I love the hair. I love her kind of green, khaki clothes. Yeah, really, really like the way that one came out. This one I'm not so keen on. I think it was just a very busy page, and I found it really difficult to work out what was cliff, what was cloud, etc. I think this again was for dragons or something. I like the water. That's got enchanted shimmer on it. There's some stickles in the hair of the fairy. I like the colour of the dragon. And there's stickles in the clouds. So that was that. Then this one. Yeah, here's one where I put washi tape around the outside. My daughter and I were doing this. We decided we wanted to do a red and orange yellow fairy. So she's got red hair. She's got some metallic in her hair. Clouds have got galaxy glitter in the clouds. Yeah, I really like that one, actually. It's quite fun. Silky crayons for the sky. Then this one I did, I think, last month or the month before. I really like this one. I went for a very Japanese inspired page. I wanted to do black purple hair, a kind of dragon-esque colours for the mermaid. I wanted the sky to represent kind of sakura blossom colours. I think it just works. I'm really happy with that one. And I've got the Chromatec glitter border for that one. So yeah, that's one of my favourites. This one was the first one I did in this book, and I think I did it around my daughter's birthday, so it just reminded me of her as a birthday girl. And yeah, I didn't like what I did with the background, so I chucked some glitter on it basically, which is what I tend to do if I muck up a page. But I like the way her hair, I like the way the colours go together on her dress, and it was just fun. It was a fun page to do. And I think that's what I like about Hannah Lynn. The pages tend to be simple and fun. I like this one. I like the red hair, something different for me, quite like bright red. Can't see what that might be. Oh, I think that's Winsor & Newton iridescent top coat on the wings, which is like a clear top coat, and it goes over pretty much anything, but just because it's really nice sheen. This is a darker skin tone for me as well. I really like the way that one turned out. This was the first one was one of the first ones I ever did. And I think this was primarily a page. I think this was primarily a page done with pencil. I think these jellyfish might have been done with marker. But I think everything else is primarily done with pencil, which is why it's not as vibrant as the others. Where, you know, all the other ones are done with a marker base and then pencil over the top. So this one is, you know, where I was experimenting and finding out how it worked. But this is an Enchanted Shimmer top coat over the water. There's some glossy accents on the jellyfish. I put some washi tape around the inside. But generally, you know, these pages hold up to using water medium, stickles, acrylic paint. But I really like using alcohol markers as a base and going over with pencil. That seems to really work for me. So, yeah, that's all of my Hannah Lynn colouring books. So I hope you enjoyed that. I'll see you again soon. Lots of love.